Hey guys, welcome to KingPup Ghost 2v2, or whatever the title is. KingPup actually sent me clips of him 2v2ing while I was sleeping. So, let's watch these. I actually never watched them. I just wanted to upload them and see how much he fails. Ha! No, I'm kidding. I just wanted to upload them to see what the games are like. So, let's do this. It seems... I don't know any of these people that he played with. So, Peter... never gonna give you up. Ha! Yes, nice name. What am I saying? I'm a bit paranoid today, I'll explain why in a sec, so it's hard to commentate, really. But he's playing against Zeus and Hades using Uranus and Thor. Nope, he's playing with Zeus and Uranus against Hades and Thor. So, pretty interesting matchup, actually. It's on Low Hunt, Oasis to be exact. And he's just taking Low Hunt. I'm not sure if... Oh, finally he found Hunt, but... I'm not sure if he's gonna take a 7 Villai Classic or a 6 Villai Classic. Ooh, idle. But, because on Low Hunt, it's a good question to take 6 or 7 Villai. 6 Villai is a rush, 7 Villai is a boom. If you do it right, so... I'm pretty curious as to know what kind of a tactic he's gonna pull off right now. And, to me, it seems like it's gonna be a 6 Villai rush. But that's not such a good idea. Oh, actually it is. I thought the Hades player was here, not the Thor player. So it's not bad to do a 6 Villai rush on this, just because he got lucky enough to be faced with the Thor player. And it seems like that is exactly what he's doing, because he's not chopping any wood, so he cannot afford more villagers either way. Alright, nice. Only a few seconds behind, so... Pretty good classic once he starts advancing. Starts. Okay, so it took him a few seconds to click advance. And now he's gonna transfer his villagers, I hope. Yep, yeah, okay. So he knows how to do this. That's pretty nice. And his partner seems to not be a good player. He's not even housing his towers. But his score isn't that low unless he's not even advancing. If he's not advancing... Oh, he is. Okay, good. So, he's not that good, but he's not as bad as you'd think. So, it's not that bad. Meanwhile, the Thor player is killing KingPup's scout with that ult suck. I hate it when people do that. It's not a bad tactic, but it's so annoying when people do it. So, he's just running back to his home base. I'm pretty sure he's annoyed right now. Oh, he should have deleted his Promethean so that he gets the two offsprings, which are a lot faster. And then he could even catch up to the ult suck and kill it. Ah, he should have done that. He could have killed that old suck, but he didn't do that. Well, I don't think he's ever seen people do that, that's why. I don't know what to say. I guess I'll explain my story like I was saying earlier. I woke up today, nobody was home, which is okay, because I was kind of expecting to be alone for the first 2 hours today. But when I left my room, the first thing I came into contact with was my backpack. My backpack was dragged outside of my room, and like, I don't even know what happened, but I always keep my backpack in my room on the floor. And this morning, it was like outside, and I'm 100% sure I didn't take it there. So that was already really creepy. But then I went downstairs, and the door was wide open. Like, the back door was wide open. So the freezing air was coming in. And, like, the last person in the house left at least an hour ago. And the back door is wide open. So, that was really creepy. I decided to go to my room slowly and just stay here all day. So, I didn't really leave my room much today. Except I got a phone call. Like, the phone was ringing. And I had to go outside of my room to pick the phone up, which was creepy. I expected the phone to say 7 days, but it didn't say that. It was just a normal phone call. I didn't want to pick it up, though, since I had to go outside of my room. But, you know, I'm not a wimp. I did it. Yeah, I'm a man now. Now, why did KingPup make an economic guild if he's not even buying any upgrades? He should be getting husbandry right now, and he can even afford it. So husbandry is the best option, but he's not getting it. Oh well, let's look at the fight. So, the enemy has relic monkeys, red's not doing anything. And, yeah, the teal player is really well harassed. It seems like he's actually running to his teammate's base with that Hearthstone. Oh, that's his own base. Wow. I thought his own base was right here for some reason. but that's on the edge of the map. He just made his temple in the middle of nowhere, and he's trying to go fast heroic, is he? Let me just... Why did he make an armory so early? Is he trying to go fast heroic? That's weird. I don't know why you would go fast heroic on low hunt. But whatever. It seems like he is getting raped by this rush that KingPup is pulling off. That relic is his. What did he pick up? I didn't catch that. Oh, the monkey had relic. Yes, that's actually a good relic. So anyways, the enemy started spamming out raiding cavalry and got watchtowers. So the best move right now is to go for the tower, split the turmoil into separate army. That's exactly what he's doing, not bad. And then just start raiding. Now the problem is that raiding cavalry are quite the counteract to Terma, but he can still take care of this. While destroying this tower, he could micro out like the Prometheans like this one and get out of the way, but it doesn't matter. He just decides to YOLO, lose some units, but kill the enemy in the process, you know. That's just how he rolls. Not bad. I'm gonna speed it up because I'm taking way too much time on this one clip. And I have more clips by KingPup that I want to upload in the same video. So he's doing a nice raiding with the Terma, finding some villagers, killing off one right there. It seems like Teal just goes into full defensive mode, losing a second tower, so not much defense left, but he does have three longhouses. At the same time, red is attacking blue. Blue seems to be the worst player in this match. And KingPup catches his villagers off guard, killed two gold miners, so that's pretty good. Going to the heroic age, taking a town center. Yeah, finally he took a town center and going for a third one. So, not that bad. And red is better than blue simply because blue just sucks. Clear out sucks. No excuses. So, what's KingPup doing? He's just camping outside of Teal's base. Okay. Okay, that's fine. And. This is so creepy. I'd explain my morning story to you guys, but besides that, it literally sounds like a door is closing every 2 minutes downstairs. And I'm the only one home. It sounds like a door is closing because of the wind. The wind is making it sound like that, but it's so creepy. It just makes me stop talking because I think somebody closes the door, but no. It's... wow. It's hard to commentate like this. Oh man. Wow. I'm gonna eat this bite. Alright. Alright, let's get back on track. Whew, I gotta ignore that. It seems like... KingPup... Oh! Oh wow, the town center had about 70 health left. KingPup almost destroyed it, but Teal used Frost on his entire army and just defended it off for a few more seconds. But it was not worth it since he still lost it. And that's the end of Teal's base, basically. He can't really build it back up because there's so many units guarding it right now. I don't think he can recover that. Meanwhile, Blue is going for a 75% Toxtoad spam. And, you know, like 25% hoplite, so that's pretty good, but red isn't that stupid. He decides to make peltasts, which are the complete counteract to archers. So, that's pretty good, I guess. Finally getting some intelligence. So, this could wipe out lots of units of Blue's army, but he's not even focusing the peltasts on the archers, so that's not doing too good. Meanwhile, KingPup is going into Teal's base, destroying the excess buildings. If I were him, I'd destroy the towers first to prevent unit losses, but he's not doing that. And he's pushing the dwarves out of their own base. Once again, he's not using the destroyers on the buildings. I'm not sure why not. He should be doing that. But whatever. Looping Cheer Blows does pretty good move since it counteracts basically all Norse infantry. Except the cavalry, but he's not even making cavalry anymore. It seems like he's not making villagers, so I'm hoping he's maxed out, but it does not seem like he's maxed out at all. 10, 18, 25. 25 is the max, but since he has 2 or 3 heroes, the max is 28, so he actually didn't go all the way. He didn't max his villagers out, and I'm not sure why he didn't do that, because that would be a really good move right now. He definitely needs food. I would make 3 more villagers and put them all on food right now. And of course, fix my idle gold miners. He has 10 idle villagers. You just start to fix them. Alright, not bad. Nice upgrades, so... Oh! Teal made an unfinished wall. That should be really useful. Wow, it actually made KingPup destroy the wall. I expected him to just go around it, but whatever. Nice! Teal is out of the game. Blue is still getting destroyed really slowly. Still in the game. And Peter decides to make a hill fort in Blue's base. Now they're both teaming up onto one base. Now the disadvantage of that is obviously no population. Oh, sorry, GG. I kind of missed it, but... KingPup was almost mythic. He could have used Tartarian Gate. Plus, they came in with a 2v1 underworld assistance. And it was GG right there. So, pretty good play by KingPup, I think. He had the highest score. I gotta make sure I don't pick the same record game again. Alright, this one. This is actually not a KingPup clip, so we're not even gonna look at this. Who cares? We're gonna look at that later. Maybe it's gonna be for a story time. Oh, another KingPup clip. So for this, KingPup was playing with his friend Jay Sharp on a high hunt map, Oranos and Oranos. So Oranos Mirror versus... Oops, wrong button. Oranos Mirror versus Raw and Kronos. Now, as we all know, if anyone chooses Kronos, we automatically know that the player is a noob. Because, it's hard to explain, but you need some, like, knowledge of the game to understand how big of an advantage is to pick Uranos over Kronos. So, if the player is Kronos, they are guaranteed to suck more than you expect. So, Hulk is obviously not a good player. KingPup is better, even though he's KingPup. I should say that. I shouldn't really say that, I mean. But whatever, let's see. He's making villagers and he's getting hunting dogs, so I'm not sure where Kronos guy is gonna fail, but I can guarantee you, just because he's Kronos, he is a noob. So meanwhile, let's look at Teal. He's making an economic guild like 1 minute into the game. That's a pro tactic, guys. Really pro tactic. No, I'm kidding. That's a horrible tactic. You should make an economic guild first thing, like as soon as the game starts, if it's high hunt. So I'm not sure why he didn't do that. That's pretty weird. And I'm pretty sure KingPup also used to play like that until I told him not to. Ooh, lots of idols. I guess these guys just like to give their villagers a rest, you know? They're nice guys. They just want to let their villagers rest after all that hard work. So that's exactly what's happening, right? Now, it seems like Jay Sharp and this green guy both seem to be bad players. Now, this is another horrible thing. Empowering your town center does not make your villagers produce faster. It does not make your villagers produce faster, I said that once again, because so many people think that empowering your town center makes villagers produce faster. It is not. I have tested it before. It does not help. I guarantee you that. So this is useless. This is just like deleting your pharaoh. It's the same thing. It's completely useless. So finally he goes out to scout with his pharaoh. But empowering your town center is completely useless. The only thing it can do is give 20% bonus resources if you drop off resources at the town center, which he's not doing. So he should be empowering his granary, not his town center. So, green obviously sucks hardcore. He just brought a whole new meaning to the word suck because that's how much he sucks. And on the other hand, what? Red actually took husbandry. He didn't even take hunting dogs. He took husbandry. So, wow. This is a horrible match. A horrible match. I can't believe what's happening. Wow. Alright, so KingPup seems to be the only guy in here who can actually play. Let's look at this view log, actually, because I just like looking at his view log, you know what I'm saying? let's see how fast he controls stuff. He's pretty slow. I don't know why he's in this one point on the screen. Oh, finally, moving his camera. Moving. Oh, he's trying to make a temple, I bet. But he needs to make a temple with this villager that just spawned. Actually, it doesn't matter. Yeah, pros usually make a temple with a gold miner. I usually make a temple with a villager that spawns out. But this is pretty good because it can secure a flawless classic. But he's going to get delayed because there's only 33 food left. He should have moved up a goat to his food spot so he can gather from the goat. So he can get a 430 classic. He's not going to do it, is he? His villagers are idle. He needs 8 more food to advance. But he doesn't realize that, and he is gonna get delayed to the classic lage. I can't believe it. He even went 4 on food, and he's still gonna get delayed. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, he's really gonna get delayed. He's actually taking... Oh, he should have taken a 5 villager classic. Otherwise, he's gonna get delayed like 30 seconds. Wow, I can't believe that. If that happens to you guys, you need to look at your animals beforehand so that you know that if your food runs out, then you have to send a goat up there to gather from it so you get a 430 classic. That's what I always do. You need to do that. And if KingPup is watching this, you need to do that, KingPup. So, that's a really important lesson. It ensures a flawless classic. You just need a flawless classic. Another thing, he should send this to wood because the gold is way too far away. He should send this villager to wood and then send this wood chopper to gold instead of walking all the way there, because this takes like 30 seconds of idle villager time. So these are really small things, but they really contribute toward the game. So you guys should pay attention to those things. Gathering his scouts a bit late if he's doing a valor rush, but he's still gonna do it. And it seems like nobody reached the classic lage, so that just tells us how much everybody sucks, because obviously I can already tell red is 15 seconds behind. Nope, he's not. Okay, he's not. Wait. Oh, never mind. I was thinking that it was 3:45. So red is really going all out with a 10 villager classic. Gonna get a 6:30 classic in there. That's pretty bad. I've never seen that with an Atlantis player before. But if he's gonna go that high in villager count, he could easily pull off a fast heroic. I mean, it's so easy to pull off a fast heroic with a 10 villager classic. It's just too easy. So a fast heroic would still be surprising from him, because he's so bad that I don't think he's gonna pull that off. So not even making a house. Let's look at the green player. Just reaching classic, and it seems like green is not even familiar with the loop button. That's how bad he is. He doesn't even loop his villagers. But does he upgrade his units? Yeah, okay, he gets upgrades. He just doesn't even loop his villagers. Let's look at J-Sharp. J-Sharp is advancing with... Wait a minute. He's advancing with 8 villagers at the same time as Red with 10 villagers. Are you kidding? So J-Sharp actually might be worse than the Red player in this game. So that kind of sucks for KingPup, because he should have had 10 villagers by the time he took classic. Wow. All right, not bad. Not actually, that's horrible. So KingPup is taking counter barracks, but no barracks. Why is there no barracks? On High Hunt, you can easily afford Mermillo and Terma at the same time. This is pretty weird. Alright, the door was open again. that was weird. I walked downstairs and the door was open again when I closed it earlier. I don't know if somebody's playing a prank on me or something, but it's pretty creepy, so I'm gonna continue along with this commentary and hope I don't die. And let's see what's happening. I kind of just cut off. Alright, it seems like KingPup is attacking the raw player. Harassing his gold miners, that's pretty good, but there are towers to let green stay safe, it's hard to say. So I think KingPup should move his units here and destroy a tower. And he could kill the snake in the process, so that's kind of what he's trying to do. But the Pharaoh is coming in to assist, and that Pharaoh could kill off all these myth units at once, which it is doing. So KingPup decides to run away, but he still loses a Promethean. Sigh, kids these days. Okay, it's not that bad, because he still killed off like 2 villagers off of green. And how does J-Sharp have more points than KingPup? Now this is the true question. I don't understand. It's so weird. I don't know how J-Sharp has more points than KingPup. But KingPup is kind of wasting his units away here. Uses Shockwave, which is a complete waste as well, because as we all know, Shockwave does not shock heroes. So his Pharaoh is still safe. The snake is delayed for a few seconds, but come on, that was a waste of god power. And he shouldn't even forward right now, because he's not making any Mermillo. Why is he not making any Mermillo? That's the question. He decides to go for a semi-fast heroic, but, you know, making Mermillo would have still been the better of an option, in my opinion. I don't know. I feel like making Mermillo would just be so much better. But he decides to go for a 10-minute heroic if he can still pull that off. I don't think he can, to be honest. He should be upgrading pickaxe right now because he can easily afford it. And then he could get more gold to advance. Oh, he's making a town center. That's why he's not going heroic. So if he would have wanted to take a fast heroic, he should have not taken town center just yet. Because then he could have almost afforded to advance. Meanwhile, Red tries to assist with a Promethean. J-Sharp taking forward town center. So this is going to be pretty interesting, and actually Red has the highest score in the game. Red, the Kronos player. The Kronos player with the 6-minute classic has the highest score in the entire game. Wow, this is a pretty crazy game. He didn't even take hunting dogs. That's how bad he is, and he still has the highest score. So this just tells us everything about the game. And I'm not sure why he didn't move his goats inside his base. If some raiders would come in, he could just lose all his villagers. Well, not lose them, but he could be forced off of goats. And he didn't even... Wow. Okay, not bad, not bad. Just keep playing. So he decides to go for upgrades. I thought he was going to go for a fast... Not fast, but I thought he was going to go for a heroic age right now because he could have almost afforded a heroic. But instead, he decides to upgrade everything in the economic guild and basically just everything he can afford, actually. So, Blue comes in with some raiders, trying to kill off one villager, which I think he's going to be successful in. He can easily kill this villager off. Yes, he killed off a villager. So he should run away right now. Perfect, he didn't take any damage whatsoever. So let's look at his perspective again. He took the score lead. I think that one villager kill kind of just gave him the score lead again. And finally, he can finally almost afford heroic. After all this time. So he should be looping villagers here too, which he's not exactly decided to do. I guess he has too much swag for that. Well, he might advance the heroic age with this town center. That might be another reason. But he's not doing that. Wow. So he just... What? He just completely wasted this town center. Alright, no problem. Let's keep looking at this game. He's going to waste two Termite Heroes on the spot as well, which he should have saved because Termite Heroes are hard to come by. I shouldn't critique the game. I guess let's just look at how wonderful the gameplay is. It seems like no micro is the new style these days because not microing your Termo away is definitely something that's fashionable these days because it can almost kill off a Cheer Ballista. But maybe if you microed it, it could have fully killed it off. But, you know, not microing, it's just so epic. It just, it makes the game that much more fascinating. So, let's look at this style of gameplay. Alright, seriously. It seems like he almost ran into Red's villagers. But, Red has an army protecting. So, kind of unlucky for KingPup. And he's not microing his units away in time. So, he's gonna lose all of them using... J-Sharp used Shockwave, alright. Nothing much is happening, to be honest. Nothing at all. Like, he's moving forward with Termo, but he's not even looping. Finally looping Mermillo after all this time. He should have done that a while ago. Nothing's really happening. And it's a good move to take Cherry Ballistas because he knows that the enemy has Mermillo. But I still say that he shouldn't go for full Cherials. Just one Cherry Ballista and one Terma. Those are the two counterbacks. So he shouldn't have actually went for full out. Oh, I think he didn't go full out. That's good. So Red is making good mix of units. He still sucks, but even though he sucks, look at his score, guys. Wow. I'm pretty sure this is a noob game, that's why his score is so much better than everyone else. KingPup is not going to be happy to view this clip, because I bet when he played this, he thought Red was really good. But I'm just completely bashing on Red. Red sucked. He was like a horrible player. And he's still better than KingPup. So, I'm really bashing on Red. So, that sucks for KingPup. Oh well, let's see. KingPup actually advanced to Heroic Age. Coming forward with a Staphylian Bird. I just thought the door opened again because it sounded like it, but right. So, anyways, KingPup actually has a lower score than J-Sharp. I'm not sure why. Seems like that's his new style these days. And he's not making a palace. He should be making a palace. Nice, he's making a palace. Taking my tactics, surrounding your town center with buildings so that's more defended off. That's pretty smart. Losing a bird, that's not pretty smart. And now green actually has the highest score. What happened here, actually? Okay, a pharaoh shot off the bird. And he has a crocodile as well. Wow, so green took the Hathor god, which means he could come in and use the locust swarm god power on King Cross farms. Imagine him using locust swarm on these farms. That would just kill off all his farms, make him lose 1,000 wood at most. Right now it's only 600, but he's going to spam a lot more farms, I guarantee you that. So, using locust swarm on Atlantean player, overpowered right there. And I'm not sure why, I guess green sucks, but he should have come in really early and sand shifted a villager away. And he did use locust swarm on his farms, but this was horrible. He should have used it later so that he could have killed off more than one, I mean more than three farms. And he even lost his rock in the process. So green doesn't pull this off really well. In fact, yeah, KingPup can even afford two more farms now, so that didn't really stall him at all. Like I said, he should have used it later when he had a lot more farms out. Meanwhile, Hulk is finally taking a second town center when KingPup already has three out. Wow. Okay. So, if I were KingPup, I'd send my army forward right here and make a town center on the spot to just secure that area. But KingPup's not really doing much, just stalling time, letting green do stuff. So green is just spamming elephants and chariots now, which is actually a good army. And it seems like Hulk is coming forward to attack J-Sharp at the same time. Let's speed this up. What's going to happen? It seems like... Whoa! J-Sharp just lost a few villagers there because Hulk ran into his food gathering spot. That was pretty lucky, actually. And KingPup taking the lowest score in the game for a second there, but now he jumps off the highest score in the game. Wow, this is pretty interesting in score count. Nothing's happening. It's really hard to commentate games that, you know, not much action is happening on because I don't know what to say. Like, this, to be honest, it's kind of a noob game, and I can't really commentate a noob game because nothing's happening. Nothing. Nothing at all. At least KingPup maxed out his villagers, but once again, this is what I was pointing out last game too. Why did he stop at 25 villagers when he could go for 28? 28 is the limit using the Valor heroes, but he did not... He does not even have heroes. Oh, that's why. Wow, that's weird. I always use my Valor inside my own base, so my villager limit is increased by 3, and 3 is quite a lot. If your villager limit is increased by 3, that can help a lot, actually, because he can make 3 more villagers on gold right now, and he could get so much gold, like, no tomorrow. And also, he should take 5, or just like 3 villagers off of wood and put them on gold, because he needs gold. Gold is the most important resource right now, because he needs to get enough gold to use the Hesperides tree and spam out drives. Plus, he needs to loop Stifilian birds. But he's not doing that. Green comes in with a massive carried army, trying to fire off his farmers. KingPup having a really slow reaction. Oh, never mind. What? Why is he shooting the farms down? Okay. Oh, that was a misclick. Good. So, these guys, yeah, whatever. I'm not going to say anything. But he was actually accidentally firing the farm down instead of the villagers, which really sucks. Meanwhile, Hulk advances to the heroic age through Rhea. And he's making catapults. Catapults are a pretty useless unit, in my opinion, and he should not be making them, but whatever. Whatever floats your boat, however the saying goes. So meanwhile, sneeze. KingPup comes in with lots of destroyers, and look at this, green actually has no counteract against destroyers whatsoever. Contrary to popular belief, chariots do not counteract destroyers. As you can see, they barely do any damage. The only unit that counteracts destroyers using Egyptian are Axemen. That's right. Axemen counteract destroyers. Nothing else counters destroyers. I guess elephants. Look at this. It does a lot of damage. Elephants are pretty good, but Axemen are their only counteract to destroyers when Egyptian. So, yeah. Green's not making any Axemen, is he? Nope, not at all. So green should be making Axemen, which he's not doing. to counteract all these infantry, actually. But whatever. KingPup's still not making any birds, and he's just wasting his favor right now. Let's speed it up so I won't be so paranoid about that. KingPup losing his entire army to Green's weak... Actually, it wasn't that weak. Green just loses... Well, KingPup loses his entire army to Green, but it wasn't that weak of an army. Finally taking the town center, like I said he should have done like 5 minutes ago. Trying to guard it, but he's not going to do a good job of this because there's so many Mythians on the field. He should have upgraded more Terma heroes, which he did, and microed it out to the Mythians. Perfect, so he killed off basically all of Green's myth. Nice move by him, taking his town center as well. I think it's GG on the spot, even though they have even scores. It seems like KingPup is gonna win this against Green. And at the same time, J-Sharp, is he winning or losing? I don't know if J-Sharp is winning or losing, but I think he's losing because he put his farms out in the middle of nowhere, and now his villagers are in danger because he did that. That's a horrible move. Why do you put your villagers there? He should have put his farmers in the middle of his base, not in the middle of nowhere like this. Even here would have been better, but whatever. Taking the most useless wall I've ever seen, basically in the middle of a forest, and an unfinished wall here, but there's still a hole, so not a great waller. Meanwhile, KingPup actually goes into Green's main town center, destroying it with destroys, leaving the Mermillo to attack the elephants. Pretty good move by KingPup, and he still is not making any birds, still can't afford anything. I don't know, every time I say he's doing good, I feel disappointed. He's just now upgrading Hand Axe 22 minutes in game, so yeah, not that good. Meanwhile, oh wow, Red actually got to the Mythic Age through Atlas, so he gets Heck. Wait, what's the name of the Mythian? Heka Gigantes. If you're American, America, then you pronounce it Heka Gigantes, but I think it's Heka Gigantes, but I'm not exactly sure how you pronounce it. I don't really care, but he gets Hekas, and those are Heka OP. Oh, you see what I did there. The Heka Myth units are actually really strong. They're one of the best Atlantean Myth units, I believe. Possibly the best Atlantean Myth unit ever. And look at how much damage it's gonna do. Wow, 2 hit a Cherry Ballista. That's how strong it is. So, Heka Gigantes or whatever are really overpowered. And Green only now using the Rain God power. Horrible move. He doesn't even have any farmers. Wow, such a bad player. He should have used the Farming God power about 5 minutes ago before he lost his base to it. Oh, he's in the Mythic Age. I didn't realize that. He has Tornado, yes. He can go into KingPup's base and use Tornado. Not going to do much damage, but it would still be worth it. Use Tornado, then come in with some assistance with Carried Archers. He did not do that. It's GG. So that's a pretty not so good game, to be honest. But, you know, might as well look at it since it's KingPup. KingPup, our hero, sent in the clip, so I just had to look at it. And this is the final clip. I'm just gonna speed through since I know this video is gonna be really long. KingPup takes Isis for this one. We haven't seen that, have we? So KingPup playing as Isis with his partner who's Uranos. Now let's see, the enemies seem to be Zeus and Odin from Hellboy. I mean, Hellboy is playing as Odin. An LGN clan member called Thor is playing as Zeus, so yeah, and KingPup playing Isis, his partner playing Uranos. Now, I'm not sure, I think his partner really sucks. Look at these idols, he's not even taking classic, not even making villagers. It's GG. Red sucks so hard. So yeah, that kind of sucks. let's see, what is he doing? KingPup taking a 550 classic. That's not that good. But I guess it's not bad since Egyptian, right? So usually when I'm Egypt, I take a 530 classic, which is still late, but it's still acceptable as Egypt. 550 is late, but acceptable. I don't know what's the max limit. I've seen pros take a 6-minute classic, but that was only when they were playing really bad. So 6-minute classic is still acceptable, but anything past that sucks. Anything past 6 minutes is horrible. It seems like they have a good relic here, the Uncut Raw, which gives bonus favor when captured, and not much else happening at all. Absolutely nothing. Green, I mean, red is not doing anything. He's not making military. He's not booming. He's okay, finally he's making a town center, but that's still a really late boom. He should have started making that, like, up to 2 minutes ago. So he's taking a really late boom, not making military, not even moving his scouts, not doing anything. And the Zeus player actually wasted Bolt on red's Caladria, or whatever. Which is a huge waste, because that unit cannot even harass. It can't even attack, so that's a huge waste, but I guess it did save him from one thing. Red could have used the Carnivore God Power on these Food Gatherers, so it kind of saved himself from doing that, but it was still a waste using the God Power. He could just sent in his Centaur and fired it down. Meanwhile, Blue is also booming. Red is not booming, just making a really weak army. KingPup, yes, KingPup is not taking a fast heroic. That's a huge surprise. He should have been almost up to heroic age by now, and then started making the town center right after. My throat is dry. I'm really surprised he's not going fast heroic. I mean, usually, to be honest, KingPup's fast heroics are like 9-minute heroics and stuff like that, you know, so they're not actually fast heroics. Yeah, whatever. I shouldn't say that because I bet he's viewing this clip, but, you know, they're never actually fast heroics. Once again, he's going to get a 9-minute fast heroic, which is not even fast anymore. It's like semi-fast heroic, I believe. Because if you're Thor, you can get a 9-minute mythic, not a 9-minute heroic. A 9-minute mythic, you heard that right, so a 90-minute heroic is not that good, to be honest. But at least he's booming, so that it's not that bad, I guess. And I'm not sure what tactic he's gonna use, because he has a lot on food, so that means he could easily afford elephants, couldn't he? But he doesn't have much on gold, so he can't really afford a mid-gall. But I guess the only reason he has so much on food is so he can afford a boom. That makes sense. That's pretty good. So he can afford a boom with all that food. Yep, that's pretty much what he's doing. And then he's gonna get gold to make a mid-gall once he's in the heroic age, which he is. Sigh. I told you guys, I can't really commentate noob clips, because I don't know what's happening. Red not making any military whatsoever. He has some idols. He has a second town center booming really badly with four idols on the field. Wow. See, I told you I can't commentate noob clips. Five idols on the field by Red. That's the same as having 15 Egyptian idols for KingPup. But he only has two. So, yeah, Red is playing really bad. But for some reason, KingPup still has the lowest score. Making a temple and siege workshop. So, it seems like he's taking the priest and siege tactic. He's not going to make elephants. Even though, I think making elephants would be the best move right now. Because not only can he afford elephants really well, but the Norse players always have so many units that have swords that they can just rape the siege and counteract the priests. So in my opinion, taking the priest slash siege tactic is a horrible move right now, because he should instead go for elephants and whatnot. This is pretty bad. He might lose this just because he's taking this tactic, and he is losing it because he's taking this tactic. Wow. Did he even upgrade his priest? Yes, he did. That's pretty good. So his priests are only 70 gold now instead of 100. But he could still upgrade the other thing that lets him do bonus damage versus minions. Now, I'm not sure why Green is pulling back, because he could have destroyed that town center on the spot. Green could do some massive damage right there. And meanwhile, Red is still not doing anything at all. Nothing. At all. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I can't believe it. So, I can't commentate this. But KingPup has so much wood and gold, he should be spamming siege towers like there's no tomorrow, but he's not doing that either. He's just camping his resources. Let me speed it up until he does something. Still looping priests, but not even making siege. Maybe he's saving up all that wood to spam chariots. Now that's a really good move, because chariots counteract every single unit Green has. So he should spam chariots right now instead of siege towers. And I hope he's going to do that. Only make chariots. He's not even making anything. Come on, make chariots. KingPup! KingPup to Earth! Or Earth to KingPup, how is it? Oh, yes! Yes, he finally looped chariots. He did a good move. Alright, so looping carrots is the best option right now because green only has infantry. Throwing axemen are considered infantry. And look at this. Green actually has gatherers as gold miners. He's not even using dwarves. That's how bad he is. Meanwhile, I think KingPup can raid with these carriots any second. He could even upgrade to heavy carriots right now. So he is doing that. Wow, he's doing exactly as I say. That's pretty good. Making the last of his houses, he should be getting fortified town center to get more population because obviously that does increase his population limit. And at the same time, he should attack or raid with these carriots. I personally would send the carriots back here to kill off all the gold miners while my main army attacks this location. And if he could toss in a few siege, which he's doing, then he could even destroy the town center. So I'm kind of surprised he's doing exactly what I say in the commentary. That's pretty good. But he's even doing what I said. He's splitting his carriots and sending them back to his mine while his main army is going to be forward here, trying to destroy off the town center with the assistance of siege. So KingPup is doing what I say, just, you know, like a minute behind. So he's playing pretty good. A minute behind pretty good. So it's not that bad. And I'm pretty sure he can make he can't make houses, but he can certainly upgrade fortified town center, which he should be doing, and taking the third town center at the same time, because he can easily afford that. Now, this is a bad map for them late game because they can't have a good trade route set up. The best KingPup can do is make a market back here and trade like this, but that's horrible because red doesn't have a town center here and this passage is blocked, so they cannot have a really safe trade route. But let's not look at that. KingPup actually fired down the ox guard that green was using, which is pretty good because now he has to walk all the way back to his base to drop off the gold. Wow. He should kill off that raider. Come on, just do it. Kill off the raider, KingPup. Do it. He's not gonna do it. Whatever. It's fine. Sorry I missed this. What? Oh, this must have had so much lag because this happened to me before. I clicked on ancestors and I used the god power, then I clicked eclipse, but the ancestors god power didn't even work. And this happened to me before. I know this is because of huge lag, because this was in a game with KingPup, and he kind of lags, to be honest. So there must have been huge lag on this game because he used ancestors then eclipse, but it didn't spawn. So that really sucks, because if he would have gotten the ancestors, he could have destroyed this town center so fast, but he didn't get that. So I wish it would have worked. He could have killed green just right there on the spot. Meanwhile, Axel, his partner, is losing it, and blue's just killing him. It seems like the two best players in this game are KingPup and LG and Thor, so both teammates are dying. It seems like what might happen is red is gonna slowly die while at the same time, oh, look at this. Wow. Blue actually ceasefired KingPup's ancestors, but this also prevented him from finishing his fortress. Blue should be taking this town center immediately. As soon as he used ceasefire, he should be going for his town center because he could easily take it, but he's not doing it. Oh, so bad. He should have taken a 30 seconds or going fully build this town center by the time ceasefire is over. He didn't do it. He just wasted all these villagers. Sigh. So, anyways, so many mistakes. I can't even count this. I'm going to speed up the rest of the game. Just hope it ends as soon as possible. It seems like blue is finally taking the town center 10 hours later. Wow, he should have built up so much earlier. But whatever, at least now red is pushed back into his base. KingPup in the mythic age and gonna kill off green slowly but surely. Green is making jarls, quite a few jarls, but that's not gonna help him much anymore because KingPup has so many units, camelry even, that, you know, jarls are not gonna do much. Blue comes in to assist with like 10 units, pretty useless. And this is what I was talking about. Green is dying, and at the same time, red is dying. Blue's still trying to come in with an assist. Does he have an underworld passage or something? He does not have an... Oh, yes, he does. He has an underworld passage right here. I knew it. Yeah. So he's coming in with army from the underworld. And that's not too bad, actually. That's a pretty good tactic. But it seems like green is gonna die either way. Once again, KingPup is not even using his favor, which he should be using on upgrades, in my perspective. He could easily buy the other upgrade that he can get from the temple, which causes bonus damage against myth units. Huh. I just heard another door close. Okay, what was I saying? Right, so it seems like, right. Like, it does always scare me, like a door closing. Huh. Okay, whatever. So it seems like green actually lost his base fully. Only two longhouses left, to be perfectly clear, but, you know, he's just losing them one by one. The underworld passage is also gonna go down sooner or later. No masons, so it's pretty weak right now, just because it doesn't have upgrades. But it's not being shot down by catapults. I'm surprised about that. But finally, he's sending in his army to destroy the underworld passage. Wow, blue should run on villager to repair it, because underworld passages repair so fast, it's crazy. They just repair way too fast. And he... Aw, KingPup! KingPup needs to get the upgrade to have 100 bonus health on his Son of Osiris, but he's not getting that. He needs to get that upgrade, because otherwise his Son of Osiris could die so easily. Sigh. He didn't get that. It seems like... I don't know what's happening. I mean, blue has this nice forward going on, but green is dead. And I don't know if blue's gonna defend this area off or not, but I don't think he is. So this is a pretty interesting game. Red actually survived somewhat. He didn't get fully killed off. And KingPup can now actually burst blue, since both of the noobish players are out of the picture. And he's coming in with a secret army into blue's main base, but catches green off guard with a hill fort back here. Green destroying his siege, but he still survived with most of his army. And now, finally, blue is starting to lose his forward base because red is coming in with useless units, but teal is coming in with actually useful units, and blue resigns first because he knows it's GG. So that's about it. KingPup sent in three clips of him playing 2v2s. If you guys want to send in clips, you just upload it to the site and then send me the direct link. So, hope you guys enjoyed this. I know it's a really long video, and it was hard to comment it because they were noob clips, but I still hope they're enjoying. Oh well, see you next time.